Pandemic has had a number of side effects, and a new Cleveland Clinic study is shedding light on another issue. Adult blood pressure levels increased during the pandemic. And this morning, we're joined by study author Dr. Luke Laffin to talk about it. Doctor, first of all, thank you so much for stopping by and talking about it. What prompted this study?
Well, we really saw that our patients were not seeking regular medical care, not exercising, making some wrong choices during the pandemic, and we wanted to see what impact that had on blood pressure.
Okay. Talk about the effects of COVID-19.
Well, COVID-19 tended to see people eating more sodium, drinking more, sleeping less, drinking more alcohol, et cetera, and those can increase blood pressure. And what we saw from April to December of 2020 was a significant increase in blood pressure compared to the prior year.
Talk about some of the problems linked to high blood pressure.
Well, prolonged high blood pressure can increase the risk of strokes, heart attacks, heart failure, and kidney disease predominantly.
Are you seeing these type of issues because of the pandemic related to high blood pressure?
We're definitely starting to see more of them as the pandemic drags on. And one thing to understand about hypertension is those effects accrue over years. So we're going to continue to see it if blood pressure stays elevated.
Because of the pandemic.
Exactly.
Well, talk about some things that people can do if, in fact, they've have high blood pressure.
Well, if you're taking medicines for high blood pressure, make sure you see your doctor regularly and get your blood pressure checked regularly.
Right.
When we talk about lifestyle factors, watching dietary salt, exercising, losing weight, and getting enough sleep are really important.
What type of medicines are we talking about for high blood pressure?
Well, there's a variety of medicines that we can take. Some people take diuretics. Some people take medicines called ACE inhibitors or angiotensin receptor blockers that are generally well tolerated and good at lowering blood pressure with minimal side effects.
Talk about the numbers when it comes to high blood pressure. What's considered alarming and what's normal?
Well, we really think about treating blood pressure with medications when the systolic blood pressure, which is the top number, is over 140, and the diastolic blood pressure is over 90.
Okay. What is high blood pressure? What I mean, you hear the term all the time, but what is it?
Well, it's essentially the pounding on the arteries every time the heart beats. So, you know, if you're 160s, 170s, it's hard. It's hard. But you want it nice and soft.
Okay.
120s, 110s.
Okay. So you're basically saying exercising and eating right and sleeping can bring down the blood pressure levels.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I mean, they go hand in hand.
Yeah.
What I tell my patients is blood pressure management is 70% lifestyle, 30% medications.
Talk about the diet.
So really what you want to be aiming for is less than one level teaspoon of salt throughout the day, table salt, which is 2,300 milligrams of sodium.
So what's the takeaway from this study that people should really, really be aware of when it comes to COVID-19 and blood pressure?
Really understand what your blood pressure numbers are. You can't neglect it during a pandemic and see your medical provider
regularly. And a lot of people aren't doing that. They're not going to the hospitals for one reason or another. Sometimes you can't get in. But the key is you got to be persistent, I guess.
Exactly. Persistent. Use the strategies that companies have in place, right? Virtual visits, et cetera, to really understand your risk factors.
The bottom line is you got to know what your numbers are. That's the key.
Exactly.
But if you're just living life and you may not have ever had a problem, what should you do at that point?
Well, you should just see a medical provider even on a yearly basis.
On a yearly basis.
On a yearly
basis.
Or get it checked at a drugstore just to do some screening and make sure you're not too high.
How important is blood pressure?
Oh, it's incredibly important. One of the major risk factors in this country for cardiovascular disease.
All right, Dr. Luke Laffin, thank you very much from the Cleveland Clinic, the author of this study showing that during the pandemic, blood pressure levels in a lot of adults skyrocketing. For more information on this study, head over to fox8.com. We have a link under Scene on TV. Chris